So you're looking to insulate your exterior walls, but you have brick and block. Let's talk about it. The good news is this absolutely can be done. Let's walk through exactly what that install would look like. Well, just like any other block project, your goal is to insulate the actual cores of those blocks themselves. What we're looking at here is a situation where you have a block-built home, but you have brick on the front. A lot of times people do this because the look of a brick exterior is a lot better to most people than a look of a block exterior. So a lot of this is just cosmetic as why it's built that way. There is some structural benefits in some areas. Masonry block building is already a really strong structure. A lot of times it's just people want that nice looking brick on the outside of their home. Now we want to approach this just like we would an average brick home. You want to drill through the mortar joints and not actually drill through the brick or cut out any bricks themselves. This minimizes the amount of damage that you're actually going to see on the bricks. When you drill through the mortar joints, you might scuff up around some of the corners, so you don't have to worry about, like I said, replacing a whole brick or trying to mortar it back in place, or again, drilling through the face of a brick itself. That's how you're going to get through the brick, but how are you going to plan out where you need to get to fill those actual cores? Because of course you can't actually see the blocks. The benefit of this install is that block is usually uniform, so you can start your pattern at the corner and then continue all the way across the face of that wall. Again, you want to make sure that you're drilling through the mortar joints and not through the brick itself. Now at this point, the install process is pretty much the same as you would any other block project. You're going to make sure you're injecting through those cores. And now the install crew will typically pre-drill holes, bottom, middle, top, and with block, it's a little more spread out. But the advantage to this way the crew can ensure that they're getting a good even spread of that product throughout the block cores. And just like normal, once this process is done, they're now going to clean up and re-mortar those mortar joints. And then once that's smoothed out, the process is done. The long and short is it's really similar to a brick project. Now I will add a caveat that it is possible that there is a substantial wythe cavity in between the block and brick. And in some cases, it is a really good choice to insulate that wythe cavity. That's all gonna be project dependent. So if you know you have a substantial width cavity, that is a good opportunity to insulate right there. And you don't have to worry about lining it up as much. It can be a different application. So just keep that in mind. And of course, if by some chance you actually have a stud cavity in there as well, very rare, but it is possible. I say rare because that would make your wall assembly 2 feet plus thick. In that instance, I would recommend trying to access that stud cavity as the best way to insulate those exterior walls. For the most part, you're going to attack it just like a normal brick application on the outside and fill those block cores like you would your normal block application. So if you have a home like this, good news is, like I said, it absolutely can be done. If you're looking to learn more about different types of installs, please go to our link below to our Learning Center. We have all kinds of articles, blogs, and videos, everything you need to know about foam insulation. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.